Welcome to episode 10 of Questions for Cole. I'm back after a week away, and I'm recording on Thursday this week because of Canada Day falling on our usual Wednesday recording day. But it is good to be back to what has become our new normal routine. I did have a couple of questions come in over the past week or so let's see. The first one is about churches opening up. Specifically about that petition that was going around a few weeks back, or as the person who sent me this question calls it, that silly petition. I think I know how you feel about this. You're not wrong. I guess a few ministers got together and wrote a letter demanding that the government let churches open up to their full capacity here in Manitoba with no restrictions. And they wanted other ministers to sign it. None of those original writers were United Church ministers, by the way, as far as I know. No United Church members have been in favor of it, not that I've heard. I'm not sure how far that petition actually got, but I haven't heard anything about it since, so hopefully it was dismissed immediately. I think the majority of you who are watching this will have received my letter to the congregation from a week or so ago, giving you all some information about where our church stands right now and how we are doing. So I won't repeat all of that. But I will say that I personally will definitely not be signing any such petition. I think we are all struggling with the way things are right now, and we miss each other, and we miss the way things were 4 months ago. But I think that we're also seeing strong evidence around the world right now showing what can happen when things do open up too soon. So many countries are having just an awful time, with numbers of cases rising, numbers of deaths rising, people fighting on two different sides of the equation, and no end in sight. I'm not in any kind of hurry to return to normal if it means potentially putting people at risk, especially people who are most vulnerable, and we have a lot of people in that category in our congregation. Every church does. So sure, we miss each other, and it would be wonderful if this pandemic just went away. But for now, we will continue to try to keep each other safe. We will follow the safety regulations that have been put forward by the experts. And we're still doing relatively well here in Manitoba, but only because we've been very cautious. We haven't pushed to open everything up earlier than when it is safe to do so. I also need to say that I've been very pleased with the attitude that our church council members have taken on this issue. They agree that we shouldn't rush back. And there is a strong sense that what we are offering online in terms of worship, as well as the midweek messages and the small online gatherings, and all of the pastoral care that is happening among members of our church, family, and beyond, all of those things together are working very well to keep people connected to each other and connected to the church, as well as we can under these circumstances. So let's continue to find ways to serve each other and lift each other's spirits and stay connected to each other, and to nurture our faith in these new ways until it makes sense to return to our regular routine. Thanks for the question, that was a good one. And the other question is similar to one from a few weeks back, but a little bit different. This one is about whether I watch my whole sermon every Sunday. Well, a few weeks ago I talked about whether I watch the whole service on Sundays, but this is specifically about the sermon. And the answer is no. I watch the parts of the service that don't have me in them, like the scripture reading and the creed and some other things, but I don't feel a particular need to hear myself over again. I mean, I've already heard the sermon coming out of my mouth while I'm recording it, and I've gone over the sermon multiple times while I'm writing it and putting it all together in my head throughout the week. So listening to it once again in its finished version and having to watch the words coming back out of my mouth on my computer screen seems like a bit much, maybe even cruel and unusual punishment. So no, other than the first few online sermons that I did, I watched those just to see how they looked and make sure there weren't any technological problems or sound issues. But no, I haven't really watched one through from beginning to end since. Thanks for that question. And that's it for this week. They were few and far between. I will be doing these over the summer too, as long as there are questions that come in. So keep sending your questions in to my email, which is cole@selkirkunitedchurch.ca. Have a good week, everyone, and I'll see you next time.